Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, all praise are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The one we are seeking His assistance, His forgiveness. And the one we are seeking the refuge in Him subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evils of our souls and the wickedness of our deeds. Whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides shall never go astray. And whomever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows to go astray shall never find guidance. And we as the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we bear witness that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's last messenger. May the blessing and the peace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon him, upon his family, upon his wives, upon his companions, and upon his followers who are going to follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with piety, with real fearing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till the day of judgment. Those who are gonna look for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure. Those who are gonna look for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure. Those who are gonna look for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's satisfaction. Those who did realize the connection between the human being and Allah. In particular, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those who did receive the book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those who did understand the importance of asking Allah for His forgiveness, which we have been talking about. And it's just the tongue. And hopefully in today's khutbah, inshaAllah, we'll be able to connect the tongue to the heart. And we realize that the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for centuries has been only claiming, but there is no action. There is no implementation. Who can deny that he loves Allah? Who can deny that he loves Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Check with the sisters, do you love Aisha? Do you love Khadija? Do you love the wives of the Prophet? And I grant you that you will never find one saying no, except those who are absolutely out of Islam, which is a different subject. You love Allah? Sure. You love Muhammad? Sure. You love the Sahaba? Sure. You love the mothers of the believers, the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Sure. How is your life from any one of those? How was your marriage? How was your engagement? How many are spending to teach your kid the Quran, and how many are spending to teach them the math and science? What's the top on your list? Their deen, your deen, her deen, or other items and other subjects? You love Allah? Yes. You love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Yes. You love the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yes. And you are the one who might give your son and your wife as a gift to the hellfire, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did reveal in the Quran. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu lima taquluna ma la taf'alun. Oh, believe, why you say what you are not implementing? And Allah is talking to the believer. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the believers, قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ. Protect yourself and your families from the hellfire. What you have been doing, brother? MashaAllah, spending money, saving money, taking them to the best places on the whole world to do what? To swim, to enjoy their time. Which is fine if it's in halal. And you will end up saying, oh, just like, but just, is it halal? What you have been doing? The place might itself might be halal, but what are you doing there? Oh, just like a little fresh, just like dancing, drinking, just like little. You love Allah? Yes. You love Muhammad? Yes. You love your deen? Yes. That is the reason. What we have been talking about, asking Allah for forgiveness, it's only the action of tongue. which is a mandatory to start the step on your way back to Allah. To keep asking Allah for His forgiveness. But we want to be very careful to make sure that the subject we have been discussing, don't forget why we have been asking for Allah's forgiveness. Because we want to be safe in this dunya and safe in the Day of Judgment. As we said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent only two ways of being safe. Either Muhammad himself is available and Muhammad alayhi salam is gone. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away. The only way after the Prophet to be safe from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ When you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for real forgiveness. So we have been asking Allah for forgiveness. But we need to be very careful to make sure that it will be put into text. You see the brother in the nightclub coming out of, or not praying, or the sister is not covered yet, and this and that. What you have been doing? You will see the brother smoking the cigarette in one hand and he has the sibha in the other hand. What's happening in the other hand? I don't understand. Is this saying subhanAllah and this saying what? No Allah? Or I don't understand. What's going on? You will see the sister almost what's uncovered is more than what's covered. And she has been talking about the verses of the Quran and how she loves Aisha and how... You love Allah? Yes. You love Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Yes. That is the reason the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did set some requirement. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did reveal in the Quran, as we said at the end of the last khutbah, there is a way for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept. There is a requirement for assured Allah's forgiveness. It can never be with tongue only. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam of the Sahaba did teach this ummah. We want to stop deceiving ourselves. People will tell you, brother, don't worry. Just you are Muslim and everything is okay. You prayed Fajr? No. You prayed Isha? No. Sister, you have hijab? No. But don't worry, you are okay. Which okay? I don't know which okay. From based on what you have made that okay. You got it from where? We have no other sources than the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of Muhammad. If you are talking about Allah's mercy and Allah's hope, there is no one did understand Allah's mercy and hope better than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He has been already forgiven. And we never heard that the Prophet stopped worshipping Allah or even more, doing more. We have never heard about any of the companions. We know Umar, we know Abu Bakr. Guys, we need to, I'm telling you, the whole issue which we have been talking about, that the charge of the reminder, the lecture, the Ramadan, is only sustaining with us for a few minutes. It's not going beyond this. It's just the excitement. Oh, it's good. Once you are out. And the whole issue is the rust that we have on our hearts. It's too thick to the extent that a reminder or two, a lecture or two can only deal with little micrometers. But there is still a lot on the top of the heart. What forgiveness you have been talking about. If Umar is listening to one verse about Allah's punishment, Umar, what you have done for your deen? For how many years you have been Muslims? You, your family, my family, years? What do you have in your record before Allah? In those too many years that you can say it's granted and you will be able to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with? Allah only knows. Umar, after 2 minutes of accepting Islam, 2 minutes, he has become al-Faruq. And no one can dispute the title because he has been given the title by Allah. 2 minutes, he has not done anything yet. He went to the same house on the top of the mountain, the house of al-Arqam, the school of the Quran, where Islam did start. which what we are putting down in most of the countries and shutting down. It's an old fashion. Just keep worrying about those sciences and this and that and Quran and that guy who's teaching our kids memorization. Just like old fashion. What the new fashion did for you? Your daughter Khadija had become Christina, and your son Ahmed has become George. What did happen? The Prophet did teach this ummah to be the top in science without forgetting that why you have been created for. 2 minutes after his Islam, he started the day with the intention to kill the Prophet. Guys, you need to understand that. Why this guy, for how many times we are finishing the Quran and reading the book of Allah? How many verses? 5 verses was enough to transfer that monster Umar to Al-Faruq. 5 verses. The beginning of the chapter of Taha. What those verses did in a man who can understand speaking and reading the Arabic language? What? Not the whole Quran. Not only a normal man, an absolute enemy to Muhammad and his deen. To the extent that the Prophet used to tell him, Umar, please let me go away. Ya akhi, leave me alone. Because Umar used to stop at any time the Prophet is preaching the public, delivering the message of Allah. Because he knows that what Muhammad will do. He always want to be a barrier. Till the Prophet told him, Umar, leave me alone. What's the issue? To that day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made his plan for one of the companions who has accepted Islam, but he has not announced that he did accept the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the deen of Allah, the message of Allah. And he made that game and he made that trick with Umar, when he has seen Umar waking up so angry on a day that he has decided to kill Muhammad, to kill the messenger of Allah. Same day. And he transferred Umar to the house of his sister Fatima. And it was the story that all of us know. Sa'id ibn Zayd, her husband, Khabbab ibn al-Arat hiding under the bed, who was teaching Fatima and her husband. And the whole thing was a piece of leather of a sheep or a goat that Fatima was holding in her hand, and Umar was listening to the verses recited. Khabbab was a skinny guy and he cannot confront Umar. And when he heard his voice, he did disappear inside the house. And he let Fatima and Sa'id facing their destiny. Once Umar got inside, show me that crazy stuff that I have been listening to. And she is holding the book of Allah, that piece of leather of those verses in her hand. I'm trying, guys, to raise a point. Hearts, we can deal with it. The problem that you might do a lot of actions, but there is no effect. You might have some good intention because the thickness of the rust is not allowing the light to get in. You need to remove one curtain, then the second, then third, then fourth, so the light will touch the heart. What those verses did in a man who was planning to kill the Prophet? What? Give me what you have been reading. She said, no. You are dirt, you are impure, you are kafir, you cannot touch the book of Allah. And it was not the whole Mus'haf, only a few verses. She said, Wallahi, you will never do it. And he slapped her on her ears. And the narration said her ring did fall down. And he was almost on the way to kill her husband, Sa'id ibn Zayd, one of the 10 who have been given the glad tidings of Jannah. And Fatima did insist, you will never touch the book of Allah till you go inside, take a shower, and come back clean. And he did. He went inside and he came back in the same house. Show me what you read. And it was what we are reciting almost every day. It was not the whole Quran. It was 6 verses. Taha. Ma anzalna alayka al-Quran litashqa. إلا تذكرة لمن يخشى تنزيلا ممن خلق الأرض والسماوات العلى
الرحمن على العرش استوى له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وما بينهما وما تحت الثرى وإن تجهر بالقول فإنه يعلم السر وأخفى الله لا إله إلا هو له الأسماء الحسنى. Six verses. And Fatima looked at Umar, that horrible guy. Face got changed. And he started shouting, but into a different direction. Tell me, where is Muhammad? And he kept pressuring her till she told him he's in Dar al-Arqam, in the school of the Quran, the beginning of this ummah. And it will remain the beginning of this ummah. And I'm telling you, if we'll not get back to the same beginning, this ummah will not come back. And he left. Khabbab came out of the place that he was hiding in. And Fatima was worrying, Khabbab, Umar would do something wrong with the Prophet. And Khabbab told her, hold on, I don't think so. لقد خرج عمر بوجه غير الذي دخل به. Umar has left with a different face. And he went up the mountain. The whole story that we know. Everyone did realize the investigation agency of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam at the bottom of the mountain, they told, oh, Umar is coming. The news has come upstairs and at the top of the mountain. Everyone started running because Umar is Umar still. Except the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Abu Bakr. And the Prophet told him, Abu Bakr, go. He said, no, Ya Rasulullah, you know that Umar is tough. He said, Abu Bakr, wake up. Inni Rasulullah. I'm the Prophet of Allah. I'm protected by Allah. What you're talking about? He said, let me be with you here. Something I can help in anything. And Abu Bakr, that's skinny. But Abu Bakr has a heart that can capitalize or balance every heart of the whole ummah. Let me stay with you. He said, no, no. Let me deal with him. If he came for something good, that's Allah's acceptance of my dua yesterday. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam bi ahad al-umarayn, Amr ibn Hisham aw Umar ibn al-Khattab. Ya Allah, a day earlier the Prophet made the da'wah. Ya Allah, give Islam the power with one of the two Umars who has the power in this community. Either the first Umar, who's Abu Jahl, Amr ibn Hisham, or Umar ibn al-Khattab. And it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's acceptance of the da'wah. If he came for something good, that's Allah's acceptance of my dua. And if not, I know how I can deal with him. Inni Rasulullah. I'm the Prophet of Allah. And once Umar stepped into the house, he looked at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet grabbed him from his garment. Umar, haven't the time come for your heart to be open? That is what we are talking about. For the rust to go. For the heart to be opened for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's light. And he made it. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Wa ashhadu annaka rasulullah. I bear witness that there is no God but Allah. And I bear witness that you, Muhammad, is the last messenger of Allah. Hear what I'm talking about. For how? What you did for Islam for years. Umar, after 1 second, he told the Prophet, aren't we on the truth? He said, yes, bala, for sure. He said, wallahi. And that was the last day of the secret da'wah to Allah in the whole Mecca. As Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and the Sahaba then said, kunna adilla hatta aslama Umar. We were down, not considered, till Umar has accepted Islam. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, wallahi, there is no way you can keep making it secret like this on the top of the mountain. I'm gonna make it around the Kaaba right now. And let me see who is gonna stop me. And he has take two lines of the Sahaba. One line is led by Hamza radiallahu anhu, and one line is led by Umar radiallahu anhu. And they went, and it was the first time for the Sahaba to make tawaf saying Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, based on the deen of Allah and the sunnah of Muhammad, since the message started. 2 minutes, the same day, Umar went to his bed, and the Prophet has delivered to him the title of Al-Faruq, the one whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used him to separate between the truth and the falsehood. Few verses. Why this man, after accepting Islam, a day passing by one of the houses and one of the sisters is reading the Quran inside. Just imagine it. You are passing by one of the houses and you heard the verse, Inna adaba rabbika lawaqa. That's it. Indeed, the punishment of Allah, the torment of Allah is falling down. And the narration said, Umar did fall down, fainted, and he went to his bed sick for 2 weeks. They are visiting him. He cannot get out of his bed. 5 words. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's punishment will be falling down. What is it? What is it? You know what is it? As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did say, ثُمَّ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ فَهِيَ كَالْحِجَارَةِ أَوْ أَشَدُّ قَسْوَةِ. When the hearts are getting solid, tough, to the extent that it's tougher, solid, more solid than the stone. And Allah is telling us, even the stone has a relationship with the creation. وَإِنَّ مِنَ الْحِجَارَةِ لَمَا يَتَفَجَّرُ مِنْهُ الْأَنْهَارِ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَشَّقَّقْ فَيَخْرُجُ مِنْهُ الْمَاءِ وَإِنَّ مِنْهَا لَمَا يَهْبِطُ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا تَعْمَلُونَ. Stones are reacting. Stones will fall down fearing Allah. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل. If the Quran will be revealed on a mountain, لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. You will see the mountain shivering, shaking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's fear. The stone cannot bear Allah sent down at the time of Moses. And the whole mountain has been fall down and it has become horizontal instead of vertical. فلما تجلى ربه للجبل جعله دكا وخر موسى صعقا. And Musa, Ya Allah, I wish to look at you. Are you sure? Allah, that's my wish to Allah. He said, fine. Look at the mountain. And if the mountain will be able to stand for it, you will be able to make it. فَلَمَّا تَجَلَّ رَبُّهُ. Once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did make it to the mountain is gone. And Musa did realize that that's not the time to see Allah eye to eye, face to face. But it will happen for those who are going to be able to make it. To ask Allah for forgiveness and act the forgiveness, act the repentance. Make it to Allah not only with tongue, but make it on their path, walking, acting, marrying, engaging, working to achieve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's assured forgiveness. Those who will make it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them. Wallahi, you will see Allah in the day of judgment in Jannah. The way you are looking at the moon in the middle of the month or the sun at the beginning of the day. إِلَى رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةً. قلوب يومئذ ناظرة. When the hearts are soft, fresh with the light of the deen of Allah, they will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, you will see it. And there is nothing could be better in what you hear and read about Jannah. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, all what you see, you hear narrated about Jannah is considered null compared to looking at the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That the reason it was one of the da'was of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma matti'na biladhati nadhari ila wajhika al-kareem min ghayri darra'a mudurra wala fitnatin mudullah. Ya Allah, bless us to be amongst those who are going to be able to look at your face on that day without an issue on that very tough day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did reveal a continuation of the same, towards the same destination. You want to say the forgiveness? You want to act it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did reveal in the chapter of Hud, وَأَنِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ
which is the tongue action. ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. Then repent, which is the heart action. And we said last time, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى. It will be the tongue action, then the heart action, then the body action, then be straight on the three of them. So you will be amongst those, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Those who are going to say, Allah is our Lord, Allah is Allah, Allah is the one we fear, and they will be straight on the same. Never ever be amongst those that the shaitan is deceiving them with what you say or what they say. إِنَّ قَوْمًا قَدْ غَرَّتْهُمُ الْأَمَانِي يَقُولُونَ نُحْسِنُ الظَّنَّ بِاللَّهِ. You have been thinking good in Allah, in His mercy, more than Abu Bakr and Umar and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Uthman. What thinking good on Allah you are talking about? And the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, you have to think good, but there is a requirement of thinking good in Allah. فَوَاللَّهِ لَوْ أَحْسَنُ الظَّنِّ لَأَحْسَنُ الْعَمَلِ. If you think good in Allah, do you think, I'm telling you, try this. Your boss is a great man. He's a very generous. He's a great, absolute, polite, this and that. Say whatever you want to say. Try after tomorrow to go to your office late and leave late and don't do whatever you are instructed to do. And at the end of the week, think good in him to give you the bonus. And tell me what will happen at the end of the week. You will come to the masjid on Friday, spending the whole day here praying to get a new job because you have been fired. That's the whole thing. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. You want to think good in Allah? Allah never said, وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. We will worship, we will act, we will submit the application, we will do the best, we will make it in the nice form. We'll make sure the heart is clean. We'll do our best to repent, even with the mistakes. We'll try to get back. Then we ask you for the help. We ask you to accept. We ask you to forgive. وَأَنِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ. The heart action is repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which will be, inshallah, we'll try to address it briefly after the khutbah, inshallah. Or in a different khutbah, because it's a subject by itself. People have been saying, people have been acting, I love you, my husband, I love you, my wife, but there is no any verification or indication of that love. You say to your son, I love you, and you are not bringing him a toy, he will tell you, you are lying. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the highest example. You wanna say, you wanna, Ya Allah, I love you, go ahead. I love Muhammad, go ahead. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Whomever obeys Allah and obeys Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Check in the books of sunnah. You will find a lot of text for how to ask Allah for forgiveness. And you will see after the text, it might be few words. And you will see after them, Allah will forgive all of his sins. وَلَوْ بَلَغَتْ عَنَانَ السَّمَاءِ. Even his sins is as high as the mountain reaching the heaven. And you keep asking yourself, why those words will do like this? Because it's not a tongue. Why there is something called سَيِّدُ الْإِسْتِغْفَارِ, the master of asking Allah for his forgiveness. اللهم أنت ربي لا إله إلا أنت خلقتني وأنا عبدك وأنا على عهدك وعدك ما استطعت أعوذ بك من شر ما صنعت أبوء لك بنعمتك علي وأبوء بذنبي فاغفر لي فإنه لا يغفر الذنوب إلا أنت. What is in it? Too much. The Sahaba used to, when you see why Ibn al-Qayyim did make the interpretation of al-Fatiha in five books, each one is 300 pages, the seven verses. مدارك السالكين بين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Five books, each one is 300 pages for the interpretation of Al-Fatiha. You will understand why Allah is telling this ummah those few words if it's done properly. Why the five verses did it change Umar? Why one verse did put Umar in bed sick for 15 days? You will understand why some of the Sahaba was enough for them to listen to Az-Zalzala. And know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. Abu Dharr al-Ghafari, when he heard the chapter, he said, that's enough, let me go. That road raper and a thief and coming from a horrible background. And he listened to one chapter. And the Prophet's telling you, hold Abu Dharr, let me tell you more. He said, no, that's enough. If Allah is dealing with us with a little than an atom, that's enough. If that's the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with us based on. And he went to the whole tribe of Ghafar, and he came back with the whole tribe accepting Islam.
A man, when the heart is touched by a word, you will understand why the Prophet, how many verses or hadith we know about Subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, when you have been saying, which is good. But you want to get the sweetness, you want to get the effect, you want to understand why is this a hadith is not for saying. It's for saying and understanding. It's for saying and connecting the tongue to the heart. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Moses alayhi salam, when he has seen the shepherd asking Allah for dua day and night, 24 hours. And Allah is not accepting the guy's dua. And Musa alayhi salam, he said, Ya Allah, I see the guy dedicated saying 24/7. And Ya Allah, if I'm in your place, I would have accepted his dua. Because Musa has a hope in talk kalimullah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, Musa, ta'addab. Cool, hold on. Be careful in what you say, on what you hope, on what you wish. Ya Musa, I cannot accept for somebody his tongue is with me and his heart is with his goats. His tongue is only with me, but his heart in a completely different direction. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our righteous deed. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our repentance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us to ask him for his forgiveness the way it should. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all of us among those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide all of us to the right path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala return all of us to the book of Allah and the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Allah, protect all of us from the hellfire. Guide all of us, inshallah, and grant all of us Jannah. Make all of us among those who are going to be able to make it on their deathbed and have their last statement in this dunya is La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah.